Hello, and welcome to this tutorial on how to use Microsoft Teams when screen sharing and communicating in ASL while using a PC. This is an App Smash with the Resource Materials and Technology Center for the Deaf and Hard of Hearing, RMTC-DHH, and Florida School for the Deaf and Blind, FSDB, Pineapple PD. My name is Candace McIntyre with RMTC-DHH.
And I'm Randy from FSDB Pineapple PD. So let's get started. So I'm in my Teams call with my students and I want to screen share with my students. But unfortunately, if I share my screen, I stay really small and it's hard for my students to see me clearly. So what I'm going to do is use an app smashing technique. And then this way the students can see each other clear, they can see myself clear, and they can also see the instructional content in a bigger frame. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to wiggle my mouse over the bottom part of my screen and the taskbar is going to pop up. I'm going to click the screen share option, which is the square with the arrow, and I'm going to click it. And then I have all these options. I'm going to go over to screen number one, which is my whole desktop, and I'm going to share that screen. So now my whole screen is shared and my Teams has minimized. I'm going to pull my Teams call back up. So now it's big. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the side and I'm going to drag over my Teams call to make it smaller. So I'm going to shrink down my students some and kind of move the window so it's in the top fourth of my screen. So as you can see, the student signing boxes have shrunk. And what we can do to make sure that we can see their signing space is click the three dots and do fit to frame. So click the three dots and then fit to frame. Now I can see their signing boxes clear as I keep setting up my screen. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my PowerPoint that I'm going to use for instruction. And I'm going to move over the window so it's showing my whole first slide. Unfortunately, I cannot use present mode because if I use present mode, it'll take over my whole screen and we won't be able to see each other, the students and myself, and they won't be able to see the content all at the same time. So now I have my two windows set up and now I'm going to go down and make myself bigger. Since I'm on a PC, I have to turn off my Teams camera so then that way I can use the camera app that is on my PC. So I'm going to turn off the camera in my Teams call that makes me not visible to my students. And I'm going to go down to the start window at the bottom of my screen. I'm going to open that and I'm going to search for the camera app. I'm going to open up the camera app and I'm going to make sure that I'm using the front facing camera. And I'm going to move my window so then that way it's showing me in a big enough space that they can see me signing. So now my screen's shared, my students can see me big. I can also see them clearly and they can see each other and we can go through the instructional content on the right. So that's one way to app smash and use screen sharing and Teams when communicating in ASL.
Thank you for watching this tutorial. RMTC-DHH and FSDB Pineapple PD are here to support you. You can follow FSDB Pineapple PD with the tag at FSDB_PD on Twitter and Facebook or on YouTube at FSDB Learning Network or check out their website learningnetwork.fsdbk12.org. You can keep in touch with RMTC-DHH by following us on social media with the tag at RMTC-DHH. We also have a Vimeo and YouTube channel with a plethora of videos of our presentations, our TA Live webinars, and some additional videos demonstrating working with students who are DHH or other tutorials. If you have any questions, please reach out to us at info@rmtcdhh.org.